Hello everyone, this is part 4 about iris fragrances. My name is Svetlana and I live in Western Australia in the city of Perth. We are in the southern hemisphere and now it's summer started, it's springtime. I'm dressed for spring and I try to dress in the colors which I would associate with the iris notes. And today part 4 is about Chanel irises made by Chanel house. And number 1 Chanel perfume with the iris is Chanel number 19 Eau de Parfum. I have this is a splash bottle and this is a pre-barcode bottle. You see it's even different type of packaging and different bottle. And I also have a Eau de Parfum version, the modern one. They smell very similar, but the old version smells a little bit less synthetic and a bit heavier than modern version. A little bit more carroty, a little bit less powdery. This fragrance was created, some say it's 1970, some say 1971, and some say it's 1972. And some even say it was a long time before that. It's made especially for Mademoiselle Chanel, and she died, actually she passed away in 1971. And the fragrance was available for her from 1970 at least. The Perthumery is a Henri Robert. If we come back to the 70s, I was born in the early 70s and it was time when I was a baby. Of course I don't remember it, but I very well remember women from 70s and I very well remember movies. It was a time when women started liberalization, the true one, not like we see now the feminists doing protests and doing crazy things. It was a true feminism started when women started becoming more involved in the work beyond home. So the role of women expanding from being a wife and mother to the more creative business life and more life like a modern woman like Mademoiselle Chanel was. And it required some sort of perfume, and Chanel number 19 seems was one of the perfumes which would meet this requirement. I was reading about this perfume and I found a nice book by Jean Moran and name is Vintage Perfumes, and it talks a lot about this particular fragrance, and it says that the Chanel company describes a slightly arrogant Chanel number 9 in terms that were also applicable to Mademoiselle Chanel as she was known, and it says forever young, intensely feminine, contemporary, brilliant, witty, outspoken, supremely confident and completely independent. Yes, it was very different from perfumes which were created for mothers. Some say it's a boardroom B-I-T-C-H. Yeah, I don't want to pronounce this word. Some say it reminds them the room which is just painted in white, but it's I would say it's a green shipper because it clearly has some vetiver notes, it has some green notes, and for me it has a, to be a shipper the fragrance must have a oakmoss note, but I identify it for my collection as an iris fragrance. Why is it? Because it's a clearly iris. It's cool, it's cold, it's distant, and it's very polite and energetic. It's very young as well because it's green. And you can find this fragrance almost in every book about perfumes. It's so special. And now, how many years since then? Almost 50 years it's in the market. And it's still popular and it's still modern. And no one says it's a granny fragrance. No single person. I never heard a granny description about this perfume. Whether you want to buy vintage or modern, they're all worth it. I heard that Parfum versions EDP and EDT, they are not the same fragrance because of concentration. They open a different facets of the fragrance. Therefore, please try all of them. I aim to have a vintage parfum just to understand how it sounded in the very beginning, how it was created and what was in the mind of the perfumer. So next one we'll talk about, it's the same one, it's a Chanel number 19, but it's a Poudre version. It was issued in 2011. For me it's like recent, 2011, it's recent. It's very similar to Chanel number 19. Actually, before I started video this morning, I sprayed 19 and Poudre on two wrists and I tried to compare what is the difference. This is much more modern. I am not a perfumer, I know chemistry, but not to that details to say what exactly is different here. But as a perception, it's a softer, more modern, more powdery. But it's the same Chanel number 19. I think it's a little bit better for those who would like to use softer versions of the Bodrum BITCH. This is a softer version. For me, it's not a Bodrum whatever. For me, Chanel 19 is a very clean, green, polite, strict, and very nice fragrance. It's one in my top five as far as I remember. Then two other perfumes. I was going to talk about five Chanel perfumes. I don't know any other orris perfumes from Chanel house. If you know, let me know. This is Misia and La Pausa. I have Misia in EDT version and La Pausa in EDP version. I was thinking whether I need to have both, other than them, they're very similar fragrances or not. So, what I will be doing now, I will spray one, Misia on one hand, and La Pausa, Misia, I don't know how to pronounce it. On the other hand, let's see. After 10 seconds, Misia feels like a rooty iris with green notes, powdery notes, some flowers, and fantastic as usual Chanel base. And La Pausa feels like a woody iris flower, not the iris root. So here I feel some carroty aspects of iris, not necessarily bad. There are good carroty facets, but in La Pausa I don't feel any. It's pretty much iris flower, even though as I said before, no one knows what is an iris flower scent. For me, irises in the shop, they smell dusty, not in a bad way, and the fresh big irises in the garden, they feel like Prada infusions diris, famous Prada fragrance. This one is more like a flower on the wood. Now we'll talk about each of them. Misia was created in 2015 as a part of the exclusive collection, selective collection by Chanel, and was named after Misia Sert, the friend of Mademoiselle Coco Chanel. They both liked art and they both liked creative things. Obviously, it was much later after the death of Mademoiselle Chanel, so she was unaware that such a beautiful fragrance will be created. It is rather feminine. Comparing with La Pausa, it's more feminine. So I think if you are a female, you would rather incline to this fragrance, and if you are a male, you would rather incline to La Pausa. I'm not advising to do it. I would say, in my perception, this is softer, more sweetie and flowery. This is more strict and woody. That's it. It's my perception. I love both of them, and actually I like La Pausa a little bit more. Don't know why. Now about La Pausa. La Pausa is relatively new fragrance as well. It's from 2016, but it was created by Jacques Polish. And I actually, if you look at the fragrances of Chanel, you will find that some of them were created by Jacques Polish, the in-house perfumer of Chanel, or his son Olivier Polish. And I am in love with Jacques Polish creations, but not so much with Olivier Polish. That's why probably it was tested in practice without knowing who are the perfumers. I like La Pausa more. That's five Chanel fragrances with iris orris. I think it's quite a lot for the house of Chanel. They don't have too many fragrances and too many flankers, and five is quite a lot. Yeah. Some say they don't buy Chanel because she allegedly was cooperating with Nazis during the Second World War, and some say they for other reasons, because too many people use it, and third say it's too expensive. Yeah, I wouldn't say it's too expensive comparing with perfumes like Roger Dove or Clive Christian, and I like Chanel more than Clive Christian, for sure, more than Creed, and more than many other more expensive fragrances. As for cooperation with Nazis, I have a little bit legalistic view on things like this. I'm thinking, who is a beneficiary of this cooperation? Eventually, the house belongs to the Jewish family, and it belonged to the Jewish family before the Second World War and after the Second World War. I understood that Mademoiselle Chanel was keeping the ownership of the house during the war, that she actually saved the house. Therefore, I think it would not be right to reject to buy her fragrances, because she allegedly was cooperating with Nazis. I probably will talk about this in another video about scandals which I started about poisons 2 weeks ago. So I like Chanel. I like their irises. They are more polite than, say, Guerlain irises, but all Chanel perfumes are more polite than Guerlain perfumes. Share with me what you like. What you dislike in Chanel irises? Do you like more Chanel number 19 or Chanel number 19 Poudre, Misia versus La Pausa, Chanel number 19 Vintage versus Modern, and Parfum versus EDT? I would love to hear it. Thank you very much to me for talking and to you for listening.